Hello everyone, my name is Shara Faisal and I will be doing my editor profile on Paul Maklis. Paul Maklis was born on April 2nd, 1972 in Melbourne, Australia. He is an editor who has been working in TV and film since the late 1990s. Maklis was an obvious choice to edit the musically driven Baby Driver because of his longtime collaboration with director Edgar Wright. Maklis also cut Last Night in Soho in 2021, The World's End in 2013, Baby Driver in 2017, and Edgar Wright's previous film as director, Scott Pilgrim vs. the World in 2010. Paul Maklis was also nominated for an Oscar and won a Best Editing BAFTA Award for the film Baby Driver. In an interview, Paul Maklis talks about being a successful editor.
For me, I realized the number one thing, fun enough, is not actually a technical thing. It's actually an emotional thing. It's enthusiasm. And it's the one thing that I am not only reminded of, but it's proven to me time and time again, that if you can be enthusiastic about what you do, and even if you're in a moment where, you know, maybe the shoot's not going well, the director's feeling a little bit unsure about things, you know, if you're there at that point sort of saying, have a look what we've done, it's amazing, you know, and just feeling really positive, it's an incredible energy to give out to people.
Today we'll be doing a scene breakdown for the film Baby Driver. Baby Driver is about a guy named Baby who is a prodigy when it comes to being a getaway driver for heists, with, of course, the perfect soundtrack picked out for every job. Baby is not in it for the long run, though, as he hopes to be finished with being involved with crime, as he dreams to drive off into the sunset with the love of his life, Deborah.
I was hoping I would catch you, too. And here you are.
Identify three of the four robbers. He killed Monica Costello.
My darling, she was a good girl. I loved her. What about Deborah, baby? Is she a good girl? You love her?
Yes, I do.
That's too bad.
Tonight.
We're doing just fine. Isn't that right, baby?
Come on!
You can't keep running, baby! There's no escape!
Come on, let's get out of here! Oh, fuck!
What's happening, baby?
I have to go.
No, I'm coming with you.
You just shot a guy!
Who?
Him!
Atlanta Police Department, you on the ground. Are you okay? Can you show me where you've been shot?
Yeah. Right there.
All of the scenes were planned very intricately around the songs in the film. It wasn't like a normal movie, where if a shot went a second or two long, you could just let it go. Every line or beat in a song was a shot they couldn't change the music to, so each shot needed to end before the next shot could begin. You can also see here that as the scene gets more intense, the cuts become faster to bring more tension to the audience. Here are three things that I learned. Timing is everything. It can make a scene intense or just the opposite. Diegetic and non-diegetic music can shape a scene. Storyboarding can ease the flow in post-production. Paul Mackless was able to cut the scenes right as they were being shot because he had every scene already cut with the timing of the music. He had an animated storyboard to help him cut. Now I have two questions for the class. Do you think the scene could have worked well without diegetic music? Do you think the music made the cuts too predictable?